for joining us here in Crossword, the Executive Vice Chairperson of CIPLA, and of course, much that you're going to learn about as we go through this discussion this evening through a very special panel in discussion and much about women power. Ladies and gentlemen, particularly about entrepreneurs, this evening talks in volumes about women power behind entrepreneurship. And we got a very special guest this evening to take us through a moderated panel discussion very shortly. We also have with us the editor of Fortune India, Mr. Saurabh Majumdar. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. We'd like to say it with a bouquet of flowers. So I'm going to invite Rachita Sharma from the publishers making this event possible and the book release to please come forward, and may I have you presenting a bouquet of love and tribute to Samina Wazir Ali, our very special guest of honor. Thank you very much, Mrs. Wazir Ali, for joining us this evening. May I now call upon Satyajit Roy to kindly do the honor of presenting a bouquet of flowers to Mr. Saurabh Majumdar for joining us this evening, our very special guest. Welcome, Saurabh. Discussion very shortly, and we get a little bit more interactive with the protagonist. We're going to learn more about women power, about resilience, and of course about what's special about Revathy Roy. But please permit me to share with you a few words of the very special protagonist around whom this book features. Revathy Roy is an exponential entrepreneur who has raised 3 businesses and 3 sons. A tedious rally driver by passion, she turned her passion to drive into her mission of driving a change for women. Her first venture, for she was born out of her intent to create a fleet of women taxi drivers, a first of its kind. Congratulations for that, Revathy. A very agile learner, Revathy pivoted her business plans with time and founded Veera Cabs after selling her first venture. And she always believes, I have an idea, and then she corrects herself to say, no, the idea has been. That is how the idea of Hey Didi happened to her, as a culmination of a decade-long rich experience with driving women in India. A recipient of many awards, to share with you a few, the Femina Women Jury Award for Social Impact, as well as she also featured on the cover page of Forbes India's first WPAR Women Trailblazers issue. Congratulations. So where have we reached? How many milestones and landmarks? Today she is empowering over 1,000 of women across 6 states in the country, and Revathy means a new beginning. Once again, this is another milestone and a new beginning. Many congratulations and all the very best. The lady, of course, behind the shadow, but still she is the driving force making the book possible, the author and publisher. Let's give it to Dr. Swati Lodha. Many congratulations for the title. I'd like to share with you a few words, though she's very unassuming and wouldn't like much to be unfolded, but let me do my duty. Dr. Swati Lodha is an author of best-selling books titled 54 Reasons Why Parents Suck and Few, and Don't Raise Your Children, Raise Yourself in 2016, among her bestsellers. Also, may I share with you Why Women Are What They Are in 2004 and in 2002. Come on, get set, go. That's what we're going to be doing this evening very shortly. A doctorate in women entrepreneurship, she's passionate about creativity and innovation, and a recipient of many prestigious awards from JITO, the Business Women of the Year Award in 2017, and the Bharat Gaurav Award 2016, just mention a few. She has mentored more than 10,000 individuals from different walks of life. Currently, she is the CEO of Publishing Infinity, a boutique non-fiction publishing house launched in Mumbai. And also all the very best for the publishing house, Publishing Infinity. Right now, I need to pause and hand it over to the publishers to get a little bit more enlightened about the making of the book and about the team of Publishing Infinity. no better lady than do it. Please put your hands together. Let's welcome Dr. Swati Lola. Thank you very much for joining us.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, all of you, for being here. While I was coming here, I was reading a small snippet which said that once Albert Einstein and Charlie Chaplin went to a place which was a film review thing, and when they were there, there were a lot of people cheering them. And so Chaplin told Einstein that they all are cheering me because they understand me, and they're cheering you because they don't. So the same is, I think, goes for books. And I welcome all of you, whether you belong or you are Chaplin lovers or Einstein lovers. We love all the bibliophiles wherever they are. And I'm in a dual role today. I'm the author as well as a part of the publishing team. So I'm the message as well as the messenger. I respect this guy a lot. Why? Because he has failed beautifully in life. He failed well in life with a lot of different startups, and now he owns 3 successful businesses. First of them is EGK Foods. I always get confused, EGK and EFG. So it is EGK Foods, where he is owner of a business. I have to learn it all from them because I don't understand GOT at all. I have learned what GOT is from him. I have no clue about it. So he's doing that business. Apart from that, they run an amazing library project, which is called Open Library Project, which is a rotational and locational library thing. And they would be happy to tell you later about it. Since we are running short of time, I'm not going to take you through the details. And our fourth partnership, that is, I'm with them in this, which is the publishing house. So it is the fourth successful business which is going to begin. And I'm sure with people like you there, the bibliophiles like you there, we are going to make a difference in the publishing industry. So over to Satyaji for a quick introduction of our next partner, that is Racheta Sharma. And then we move on to who is Revathy Roy.
Thank you that we have is, since we live in such a digital world, what we're going to be able to do with this publishing house is actually create content in a digital format along with the physical format, which allows for social integration across all the social media platforms. So that's something we really look forward to. It will be out in a month or so. So we'll be sharing that book with you as well. The same book in that format, which is called the Pi Books format. So I'm going to introduce our third partner, Racheta Sharma. So Racheta and I work together at the Open Library Project, and we've been working together for about a couple of years now. And before joining the Open Library Project, Racheta was a very successful banker, and she's given up a very successful banking career to run libraries with me first across the world, and then that led to us doing a podcast called Paperback, where we have industry experts coming and discussing non-fiction book recommendations with us. And finally, this has led to the publishing house, where we are going to now move from curating content to now creating content that we find is valuable in the world. So her passion for books, her passion for learning is unmatched. I think to give up such a successful career to follow your passion is something that takes immense courage. And this is an amazing partner to have, as Swati has said earlier as well. So over to you, Racheta.
Thank you so much. So I'm the cranky one in the group. I usually get senti at these things. But it's so overwhelming to see all you lovely faces here today. And thank you so much for being a part of our very, very big day. And from being a banker to books has been a very tough decision, but something that I'm very, very proud of. And my mom and dad, who I know in the audience today, have supported me throughout this journey, and for that I'm eternally thankful. I love you guys. So the Open Library Project is a non-fiction book library service which we offer to businesses on a subscription basis. And Satyajit and I aimed to curate learning across various categories and industries for our readers. And a natural extension to that was Paperback, which is our podcast series, which we started with in association with IBM Podcast, and also now Publishing Infinity. Why I started Publishing Infinity is because after reaching a point when you're curating learning and trying to streamline learning for people, I realized that we also should be able to provide valuable content. So not only curate, but create valuable content for our readers. And this is one step towards it. Another reason is definitely more dignity to authors, better royalty rates, because we feel that they are really the true heroes of their story. So Publishing Infinity is an attempt towards, you know, interaction with audiences, royalty rates, which would be more dignity to authors, and yeah, getting valuable content out there. And Swati, Satyajit, and I aim to, you know, share more inspiring stories within the future. I would just want to make one mention about Swati. So when I met Swati was when she came on our podcast series for 54 Reasons Why Parents Suck. And that's when I knew that, you know, she's a prolific writer, and she's also one of the most she accepts response so well. So she's also done a doctorate in women entrepreneurship. So that's amazing. But after I started working with her, I realized that she is full of determination, perseverance, grit, and I'm very proud to have you as a partner, Swati. So thank you. We shall continue the event. Thanks, Alan.
Thank you very much, Rachita, and all the very best with your future endeavors. And now, folks, wherever you happen to be, whatever you happen to be engaged with, it's time to get a little bit more wrapped up with the book. And nothing better than to be part and parcel, tuned in to this evening's very interactive and, of course, very absorbing panel discussion. To lead us on, may I firstly invite our moderator. Thank you very much, Saurabh Majumdar, for joining us. May we have you at the desk. The protagonist around whom this evening is all centered, welcome Revathy Roy. May we have you joining us. Welcome Revathy. And may I invite Dr. Swati Lohra, kindly join us, may we have you. And along with Revathy, here is a very special panelist. And it's time to go through with an interactive evening. Thank you very much for joining us. So over to you.
For entrepreneurship. I have here with me two very accomplished ladies, and it is absolutely a privilege and a pleasure to be engaged in conversation with them. When Revathy actually, whom I know for a while now, even earlier in my earlier avatar as the editor of Forbes India and now of course with Fortune India, it's very difficult to, you know, say anything else, but I'm delighted to be here because she just said she wanted me to be, you know, moderating this panel discussion, and here I am. So it's something which I feel that is an important story to be told, and I think everybody, each one of you here, and those who will read the book. I was going through the book, and I can't help commend Swati for the manner in which she has told the story. It is extremely conversational. It is something which immediately touches you. Even a few words and a few lines you read touches you a lot and hits the soul of the book and the story. So beautifully told, and it's a story worth telling. So on that note, I'll get down to business right away. First question to Swati,
yes.
Who is, as she said herself, the messenger and the message. So Swati, why Revathy Roy? And briefly, to start off the discussion, who is Revathy Roy?
That's such a brilliant question I've been trying to answer through the book. The title of the book says, Who is Revathy Roy? And we had a very interesting conflict on the same, because Revathy was not very keen on having the title, Who is Revathy Roy? While the book was going in the print, she told me, can you make this who is as small as possible so that it becomes invisible? So I said then, it doesn't make sense, Revathy, so it will remain like that. And that is how we had this statement out there, who is Revathy Roy. For me, all the people who are here, many of you would be knowing Revathy Roy for a few years, maybe more than that. But I would like to tell you that you don't know her. Read the book and you would know who she is, what she's made of. And those of you who have only heard about her, of course, then you must read the book to find out who actually Revathy Roy is. For me, Revathy Roy is who she is for two reasons. She is who she is despite of what happened to her. She is who she is because of what happened to her. And what happened to her, all the choices that she made, all the challenges that she faced are all there in the book to see. And then you ask me, why Revathy Roy? Which means, why did we choose to write on someone like Revathy? It has a very interesting story. As we were mentioning 54 Reasons Why Parents Suck, my previous book, so Revathy and Satyajit, they both read that book and they loved the book. I am surprised a mother and a son liking the book together, but of course that happened. And so what happened was, they both, we kind of thought that we'll meet for a family dinner. We met, and at that dinner, my husband, Shailesh, he just suggested to us that you guys should start a publishing house. And since I'm one of those wives who takes the husband seriously, so I listened to him. And here we are, we started our publishing house journey and we started it. And on the very same day, all the children, they spoke to Revathy and they were like, you know, we must do a book on you. She wasn't very keen in the beginning, but then we all forced her into it. And I must tell you, I didn't know the whole story at that time, whatever she had gone through in life. But I was very keen to do the book, so I said, I will write it. And later on, she told me that she had me in her mind whenever she had thought about someone doing a book on her, because she would get these compliments all the time that you must do a book. There must be a story done on you. So it was uncanny, and somehow we came together. And why I wrote about her is very simple. My philosophy in life is very simple. I respect a person for excelling in different roles that they play. Revathy is one person who excels as a person, as a partner, as a parent, and as a professional. That was one of the biggest reasons for me to choose to start a publishing house and also to talk about someone who's a woman, who's an entrepreneur, and a lady who's made of immense amount of grit, courage, and today she's putting out her vulnerability there for all of us to see and to learn from her. So I think this is what Revathy Roy is and why we needed to talk about her.
Right. Revathy, you've been written about in magazines, in newspaper articles, and you know, and in the media out there. But what was your initial reaction when, you know, it was decided that there'd be a book, because your journey clearly is still on, very much on, and lots more to achieve, I'm sure. So what exactly was your initial reaction? Because a book is a big deal, frankly.
Yeah, I think the book is really a big deal. I mean, you know, when I walked in here and I saw all those copies there, I was so embarrassed. I really didn't know how to react, because it's really embarrassing. And it's just, I'm seeing myself all over, you know. It's not, I don't know, it's not comfortable.
It's like the film posters.
Yeah, it's like crazy. But yeah, I actually did get conned by her daughter and my boys. Because I don't know when and what moment they actually convinced me that hona chahiye, you know. And I think in one of my weakest moments, I said yes. And they really took it seriously.
Thank God.
Even today, I was telling somebody, I can't believe it that we've actually done it. I always thought ye 3-4 mahine mein kahin to, you know, fissur jayega, and you know, everybody's going to forget about it and I'll be back to my comfort.
She doesn't know who is Swati Lodha.
In fact, I must tell you that
we need a book on that, probably.
After the book was written, I one day told Swati, I said, I think Swati, we should not publish it. And she said, hello, it's not your choice anymore, it's mine. And I said, now I'm done. So it was difficult, because I think I have really put my vulnerability in the book. It is like Brené Brown says, that if you have vulnerability, you have courage. So I think I'm very vulnerable at the moment, because my life history is in the book. And well, it's there for people to either judge or not judge.
So tell us a little bit about this, you know, driving bug which bit you very early on in your life. Because, you know, you've been a rallyist, then you've started a business, two businesses actually or more, which revolve around this whole passion of yours. So tell us a bit about how it all started in the earlier years.
So I'm a rally driver by profession. and I've done about 85 car rallies. I've won 80 of them. And yeah, so driving is completely in my blood, passion, everything. I mean, I can eat, sleep, drink, think driving, you know, and I love cars more than I love human beings. So, because they're so not moody, you know, you can, there's no human man-made interference in the car, and you can just fill it with petrol and water and whatever, and it really moves. It doesn't give you mood swings. So, it really makes me very happy to drive cars. And it was, and I'm a teetotaler, I don't drink and smoke, so I'm forever dropping back my drunken friends back home. And I've done it all my life. I'm 59 years old now, and 41 years I've been doing that, and I still do it. So I realized one fine day that, you know, next morning when I get up and I actually call my some drunken friend and I say, you know, are you okay? No hangover now? And they turn around and say, okay, you dropped us. And I was like, look, man, I mean, you know, they're not even grateful that I dropped them. So it was a one fine day that somebody said that to me. So I got off the car and I said to them, I said, just go back home on your own. I'm not dropping you back. Because they kept telling me how to drive. I mean, you know, imagine telling me how to drive. Because I really think...
There were all men in that car.
Yeah, there were all men in the car.
They all were telling her how to drive. And that is why she...
Yeah. You know, I just said to them, no. I said, you know, you can't tell me how to drive. I'm normally very modest. But I'm very immodest as far as my driving skills are concerned. So I think I'm the best driver in the world. No one drives better than me. So, you know. So... That is how the concept of a women's cab service actually started. Because I said, let me drive women drivers and women passengers. That's how my first company, Forshi, started. I sold my company way back in 2008 to INFS. And then I started another brand, and I now started the third brand. So I'm a serial entrepreneur.
That's great. The next phase of your journey, what are the kind of challenges you face, not just as a woman entrepreneur, and you know that we'll come to a little later in the discussion, but what were the challenges you think? What were the biggest challenges you faced? Many of which are in the book as well.
So I think one of the biggest challenge actually was that I was entering a male domain. In 2007, there was no concept of a woman commercial driver. So I became India's first woman commercial driver. I drove as a cab driver for 10 months. That's how my journey began. I actually drove a cab on the streets of Bombay, not for glamour. I drove the streets of Bombay because I had to make a living. My husband had passed away and I had no living. I had three lovely boys to bring up. And I had no money. You know, nobody would give me a job. I'm a master's in economics, but I couldn't get a job. And of course, there's a history to it. But the point is that nobody wanted to associate with me. Nobody wanted to give me a job. And here I am at this stage. So.
And when exactly did you decide to turn entrepreneur? You know, that decision is an important decision which has actually led to a lot of what you've achieved. So when did you decide?
I didn't get a job. Very, very seriously, I never got a job. So how would I earn? How would I bring up my children? So the only thing that I knew, the only talent, the only skill that I had was driving. So I simply decided to become a cab driver. I mean, that's what I did. And I used to take back home some 800, 900, 1000 rupees a day back home, and I got food on the table. So those were tough days, but I decided that, you know, I wouldn't give up.
No, and thereafter the Forshi and the others.
Yeah, so I kept driving and I decided that I want to skill the women who are less privileged than I am and create something which is so empowering and so beautiful that everybody would look at it and you know, they would make themselves really financially independent. So my reason for entrepreneurship is really that. Maybe Swati can answer the question.
I would like to add on
something wrong.
No, you've not said anything wrong. Why I took the mic from her
because
is...
Because Swati knows me better than I know myself now.
Last 4 months of my life have been where sometimes I would sleep at night and think that it is not Swati, but maybe...